Right, I'm going to show you what to buy and what not to buy when you go into Mercadona. Okay, favourite oil. Use the, I've had the shade for a while. This beer here.
Classico.
This is,
okay. Okay, so much so that you've drunk it for 20 years.
Yeah, I've drunk this for 20 years. And to be fair, it tastes okay. Let's put it this way, what you don't want is this stuff. This you'll see everywhere, cruise camp boat. It's what all the construction workers drink at around 10 o'clock in the morning. It's disgusting. You know, Mare is not too bad. San Miguel, I can't stand. If you've got your dog with you, this one, that's all right. If you've got your dog with you, that's nothing wrong with that. And we mix that with another dog food that we get, but we actually get from a pet shop. It's quite expensive, but you know, you've got to give your dog the best. So we give her some dry from the pet shop, which is very expensive, and then we mix it in with this, and one tin will last us, mixed in with the dry, about 4 days, so four servings from that. Anybody want to feed the local wildlife, if you're down here during the winter, they love this stuff, so I always get this for our birds outside our house. It's like an aviary, because we've got a big bush full of birds all year round. Yeah, and the nuts, these are very nice. They're coated peanuts, honey coated. Mayal, that's honey. Okay, so they're honey coated peanuts with salt, and they're nice, and I mix them in with various other nuts that I get from various places. Aquarius. But they do a cheaper, and it tastes the same, and this is much cheaper, and as you can see, that's 106 and that's 196. So just depends what you're looking for. If you're saving the pennies, that tastes exactly the same. Doubt that it does what that says that does, but you have to go to a pharmacy for what, Charlie? Most things.
Painkillers,
you need to go to a pharmacy. So which one of these do you use? I know nothing about this.
I used to use something like Ariel, which that's like €8 now, so I've gone for the cheaper powder, which is only €4, and there's nothing.
So you use the powder now?
€4 for that
bottle. I can fit a washing machine, but I can't use one. But you know, I do cook. I am a cook. Although Charlie's a qualified chef, a retired qualified chef.
Very washing up liquid.
Stick with that, yeah?
Yeah, because the cheaper stuff, you just go through
it. You just go through it, yeah. Cheaper, sticking with the top brand, as most people know anyway. Fly spray, if you've got problems, whatever you do, do not buy this. This stuff will, well, it's so strong. It's supposed to be lemon. But it's too strong. So just go with the regular one if you use it. Normally they have a wasp spray, but obviously it's winter. But they do a small can, because we do get a lot of hornets over here. And that stuff will kill them instantly. And then you've got your regular fire lighters and coal, absolutely fine. You use that.
Brooms and broom heads and stuff. Plastic cups, those are really good.
These plastic cups are good, because if you don't know, we look after villas in the summer, so clients, so as you can see, you can drop them, they don't split. And those are one, how much are those?
160 for 10.
So yeah, coming over here and you want, these are reusable, these will last you a few years. If you're in a motorhome, this is the one, this one. That, this one here.
Yeah, it's the cheap version, isn't it?
255. That works fine in the toilet. That won't block up the cassette. And then the regular kitchen roll is fine.
Oil, they brought the price down, did they, for about €3. It used to be.
Yeah.
This used to be about 99 cents. Now it's just over two. But it used to be, went up to 3.
99 cents that used to be. That's what we, well, we don't really use much oil now because we have an air fryer. This balsamic's fine. If you go to a country and you want to know what they eat, what's their main food, check out the crisps. And the flavours of the crisps tends to be what they eat.
Red ones.
Yeah, these ones are good because you get two in a bag. Two separate ones.
Yeah, those are good, aren't they? Two in a bag. Show these inside of them.
Two in a bag.
Yeah, you get two in a bag, so.
And like everything, they've all gone up.
They're not going to go soft.
But then a bag like that's only 90 cents. That's twice as much. So.
Yeah. These are fine.
Nothing wrong with any of
them. Those are okay, 90 cents. Or if you want to go for the nicer crisp, these here. These ones here. Extra crunch. Yeah. Those are a little bit like kettle. They're not as tough as the kettle, but they're not as hard as kettle, but those are a premium crisp.
Always have got Lay's, but they just don't have many flavours.
You've got your Lay's, same everywhere. Not many flavours. If you want a nice crisp selection, probably better off going to Carrefour. Pringles, I mean, we've just been in Lidl. I didn't show you in Lidl because they changed the food around that much, this video would be out of date within a week. But we don't have the Pringles, we have the cheaper one that they do in Lidl. If you look for the cheese and chive in Lidl, or the plain, and they are half the price. Gambas is prawn. And if you want a nice cheap fish that tastes fine, we use it for the barbecues in the summer, and that's the Dorada. And that Dorada is $7.75 there, look, a kilo. And that's a nice barbecue fish. And then the other one I would recommend is trout. Trout is really nice. Do not have Melutha. Melutha is disgusting. And it's very fishy, Melutha. That's what the Spanish mainly eat. They get it from the north. They have all our Melutha because we don't want it. And I think it's pollock. This barbecue sauce is what we use. I'm not a big fan of barbecue sauce, but that's fine. To be honest, I tend to make my own, but that's me. Crispy onion, cabola. Oh, and while I'm on about, and while I'm pronouncing things, it's not, I saw a lot of videos this year and people are calling it Mercadona. We're not in Mercadona, it's Mercadona, the C is a K, Mercadona, not Mercadona. This is like McDonald's sauce that you get with your Big Mac. It's very good, very nice.
It's a bit strong.
And Charlie uses this Caesar. It's okay. But you like this as a dip,
yeah,
don't you? Charlie uses this as a dip, it's a yogurt dip. The Caesar's okay, I don't really eat that much salad, should eat more. The mayonnaises are okay. Which one?
I do have Hellmann's, which...
Yeah, I mean, I always pick up Hellmann's, but I don't eat much mayonnaise either, because I don't eat mayonnaise myself, so I leave that to Charlie.
Oh, it's really good,
that Ligresa. Yeah, the Ligresa is a cheap one, and that's not too bad compared with the Hellmann's. Ketchup, we always stick to Heinz. And the mustards, no, I always buy English mustard, so...
If you're cooking, something like this is okay, but it's a bit stronger. Vinegary.
Yeah, it's a lot more vinegary, yeah. And then the olives, if you like olives. I know that's a kind of a marmite with people. I don't mind olives. You get given them a lot when you go have something to eat or a drink. These ones are quite nice. I've had these before. Those are nice, which you can get. These ones, I'm not so, don't like these ones so much. I've never had the tinned olives. Yeah, these are good. If you like your chilies, they're not very
hot.
They're
not too hot.
They're not hot, so those are nice in vinegar, not in brine. And that's about it with those. Olive oil, you know what to have. You know your good olive oil, just check the price. Let's go back around this way and I'll... Now the prawns used to be about €7, €7.50. And that's currently the price of the prawns, €10.95. A lot more expensive. Now if you like your nuggets, I always, if you like the chicken nuggets, go for this brand here over this brand. That's turkey and that's your chicken. So that's turkey, that's chicken, and these are good. I do a sweet and sour sauce with these rather than making my own. Nothing wrong with those nuggets. What else is there here? Can't see anything that we use. These churros. Now I have seen people, these churros here. What's going on? These churros here. They're a bit like donuts, long donuts. And don't make the mistake I have seen people make when they've ordered a hot chocolate thinking they're going to get a regular hot chocolate like you do in the UK. You're not. It's to go with these, and it is literally a cup of melted chocolate. Okay, and that's why. So be careful if you order a hot chocolate in a normal Spanish place. And there's the bacalao. Now, bacalao. There you go, bacalao, cod. Okay, so that's cod. That's, there's nothing wrong with that. I know it's frozen, but it's okay. Pizzas, I wouldn't recommend any of the pizzas in here. I'm not a big fan of pizzas. I know that sounds weird, but I'm not. I wouldn't bother with the pizzas in here. All these ice creams are fine. They do what they say. Nothing wrong with those. And the chips, the blue ones at the top there, patata horna, those are the ones we do get. Although I'll be honest with you, we do go and get English chips from Iceland. Those large chips there, those are more like your potato bravos, quite thick with the skin still on. The peas are fine. You get the peas from Mercadona, there's nothing wrong with those. If you like me, I'm not keen on peas either. These frozen mix is quite good. Those are alright if you like that sort of thing. These are all okay. They normally have a strawberry one, which is the one I get. They haven't got it today. The strawberry one's really nice. Veggie Mercadona. Sometimes there's lots. Now, depending on the time of the year, the price of strawberries changes. A lot of it goes to the UK, especially during Wimbledon. And we don't get any when Wimbledon's on.
No, in the summer we don't get any strawberries.
No, we don't get strawberries in the summer. The other way around in Spain, we get our strawberries in the winter. Is there anything here? Yeah, the salads, these are quite nice. And what I always do with these, when I've opened these, I'll put a piece of kitchen roll in, stops them going off, slows them down anyway. So we get a mixture of that one, which is like large, you know, like watercress, this one, which is like the peppery rocket, and then we get this one as well, and we mix them all together. And also, we do the spinach.
Guacamole, it's just pure avocado.
Yeah,
we just wanted the dips, it's really good value. We get a bigger one, $3.50.
We've kept them. You're not having them. Brexit. No shortage of tomatoes in Spain. I remember when I was a kid, potatoes used to take ages to cook. These cook really quickly and they make good chips. They're a good all-round potato. There you go. Then we always get, we don't need to get oranges. You can see how expensive the oranges are and the mandarins. We have a field of oranges, so about 100 trees and a couple of lemon trees, and we have some mandarin trees, which Charlie is, there's about four mandarin trees that we have, and Charlie's almost through all three of them, three or four of them. Apples I get, they're nice and cheap. These ones are fine. Not these ones. I mean, I prefer Pink Lady, but those are okay though. And this used to be for nothing. Look at the price of it now. Now they do a bacon in here, but let me just... There's a chopped ham. Now that's just like the chopped ham that we normally get. And this is the pate that we use. Sort of like a... What would you call that? Pate campana, but like a crunchy pate. They also do another one which is sweet, that one, and that line of whatever that is, yeah, cranberry, line of cranberry in that one. Not too keen on that. Regular pepper, and then that's just a herb one. But we use, oh yeah, and that's the bacon that we bacon there. It's okay, nothing special. These sausages here.
German sausages.
German sausages, those are great. So those are your bratwurst. And those are great to cook. And eat those with some crispy potatoes. Here's all your, normally there's somebody always here putting this stuff up. And then they pack it themselves. So this is all freshly done here. Here's the machine that they use. So they slice that up, put it in there, and then you can get it. This, so instead of doing that, this one we get, and this is fine. This is the, we've tried them all, and that's about the best for the price. That's okay. How do you eat yours? I like it with pear. Tin pear. These mozzarella balls, these are nice. And mascarpone, we use that one. Feta, it's fine. Or I tend to go with this and put it on pizza. And that's just a big ball in water. But the cottage cheese is really nice. Do you want to get some?
Yes.
Love that. Bit of honey.
The cheaper versions of Philadelphia, these ones are absolutely fine.
There you go. Instead of paying that, get this one. See. Save some money.
Some cheesy triangles.
Yeah, cheesy triangles, home brand. Nothing wrong with those, just the same. So we need
some of that, yeah. That's just the mild version.
But you've already got
They do a stronger, the mature version as well, which is the same.
Stronger for cooking.
If you want it.
What Charlie goes for, and then that's the one I have.
These cheese slices.
That's the one I have. And then there's the cheese slices, and those are great.
Burgers.
And where's the cheese that we...
Solar, brie, it's really cheap
one. Oh yeah, here you go. We have this one. This is cheap, 163. That's fine, that's all right. That's the honey that we have.
Plenty of jams and stuff.
Jams are, as you may know, you can't go wrong with the Spanish jams. For what the price of them, it's just so cheap. And of course, they've got all the fruit. So it's good. Those are the pineapples that I get. This is just a regular apple sauce. It's massive. I tend to buy this, and then we haven't got any actually.
Just no, throw it away.
I know, because I didn't put it into smaller portions. This is great. So if you're having your pork and apple sauce, but you need to portion it up and put it in the freezer, and it comes out fine. That's what we use. Pineapple, tin pineapples, three tins. That's great. And there's nothing special. Yeah, if you want to make your own paella, not paella. Two L's is a Y in Spain, okay? Mallorca, two L's, paella, two L's, Marbella. It's not Marbella, it's Marbella. Anyway, that is good. Got sachets in there. Split those out and sprinkle that in when you make, sprinkle that onto the rice when you start cooking it. That's quite nice on...
Provençal.
Yeah,
chicken.
Provençal. Ribs, chicken wings. That you can sprinkle on fish or chicken. I've never used that on chicken, I use that on fish. Bay leaf.
So those are all right when we do it in caramelised onions.
Yeah, there's a lot of sausages. The ones that we get, if you have a look, you'll see these are the same ones, just a smaller version. They've got like I don't know if you can see that, like a string attaching them. It's a bit of a pain. You have to cut each sausage off that and then make sure you throw all the string away. Those are the nearest you're going to get to a normal, regular, no spice sausage, like a normal plain sausage in England. It's never going to taste like a normal sausage, but this is a black pudding.
The mince is really good because there's no...
This pudding is pronounced Morcillo, black pudding. Port mince, fine.
They're
nothing
all
wrong
really
with that.
Good because there's no fat in it, there's no extra fat.
Yeah, you use the mince and you'll find there's a lot less fat in the mince than there is in the UK. Yeah, so pork fillet, this is great. Cut it up, fry it, or whole, whatever. And for the price?
€3. Well, that's €4.
Yeah, that's €4. How much is it in England?
That's £3.50.
It's a lot more than that in England. That's cheap. Because Spain, in the north, they grow the pigs. This stuff in Spain is quite traditional. What they do with this is they'll throw it on a plancha and you'll have it in a bun. That's it. They don't even put butter on it, nothing. It'll just be hot. When I used to do the motor racing, and you used to go into all the cafeterias at the motor racing circuits, you would just get this in a bun or a baguette. It's very cheap, as you can see again. The ribs, these are normal ribs. They're not Iberico or anything, because you can make a mistake and pick up ribs and it's not normal pork ribs. It's the Iberico, that's a different type of pig. Chopped tomatoes, we get those. Nothing wrong with those. We don't really get much tin stuff. And this is tomato fritto.
Any of these, if you're making bolognese or tomato sauce, any of them are really good.
Those are all good. Not for me, but there you go. That is rice pudding. I always make my own. These tiramisus are okay. Yeah. And if you like these.
Those chocolates.
Chocolate. Pop them in the microwave. Tiramisu for the price. Which ones? Which caramels? These ones, yeah, these look like cheap caramels.
We'll try them all. Get the cheapest one.
Go on, sorry.
If you ever get anything in here, don't go to the more expensive ones, go for the cheaper ones, they're so much nicer. They're 6 for a euro. I mean, they used to be about 60
yeah.
cents.
6 for a euro.
They've gone up.
And all these
all
ones.
All these puddings are so good.
Yeah.
Yogurt.
We go for the that one, Greco. And you've got the natural. And then you've got the sugared one. That's a sugared one, isn't it?
Yeah, this is.
And that's the sugared one. That's with sugar. That's plain. These are all nice. Nothing wrong with these. They'll do what they say. And this crunchy, fruit crunchy stuff. This is the one that we have. This one. And that's really nice. It's called muesli crunchy. And they come in little lumps like that. And it's nice. And that's, let's see, it's cheap. That's a good one, that. Yeah. They've got cornflakes. One lonely Weetabix. Rice, I don't tend to bother with any of the rice. I buy my rice from an Indian supplier. Like you say?
We get the Basmati rice because it's the best.
If we run out of the one that we normally get from the Indian supplier, that's not bad. That's about the best one here. Long grain rice. I have the extra long grain rice, which is what you get in the Indian, and it's amazing. It's beautiful. Now I did see some. This is what I wanted to get. I saw somebody do a dish with these the other day. They made their own. It was like refried beans, and they put onions, tomatoes, garlic, and you have to cook these, throw the water away, then do it again. I wanted to do that. They're not cheap though, are they?
No, but all these jars are all ready, done, and ready for.
Anyway,
you.
Yeah.
You've got lentils, you've got
peacock.
Peas, you've got kidney beans if you want to make chili con carne. I mean, all these things are,
yeah,
they're all so cheap.
Kidney beans.
If you're vegetarian.
We have the peas, we have the chickpeas, and I make a dal with those. Charlie likes the chickpeas, and I like these lentils.
Those are lentils, yeah.
Yeah, and I make a dal with those. I like my curries. All the pastas are fine. That's the one that we have at the bottom there. And we also have this one if we're doing tagliatelle. It's nice. But I mean, you could use that for Chinese noodles, I suppose.
Yeah.
Now the rice, now the water, everybody has a preference. Everybody has their own preference for water. The only one that I don't feel that tastes of anything other than water is this one. That, Font Natura, and it comes in a large one, a small one. And that's not got any horrible taste. It also comes in a large, normally. They haven't got it. There. Where are these cheap versions of Kinder Bueno?
If you like nuts, you'll be alright in Spain.
Yeah. These. These are like a cheap Kinder Bueno.
And
yeah, there you go. I'm not sure it's the white one, but nothing wrong with those. In fact, I buy those every now and again. Shall I get some today? No. I eat the whole lot though. That's the problem. They're gorgeous. So yeah, so if your kids like your Kinder Bueno, get the knees. You can get two of those. Well, not quite two, but yeah, we've had those in the past. They're all right. They are similar to what they look like.
Cheap croissants.
Cheap croissants. I mean, I wouldn't recommend it to anyone that's loving the croissants, but
bread and butter pudding.
Yeah. What do we use them for?
Bread and butter pudding.
Yeah. If you like your bread and butter pudding, get these. They're $1.95. Throw those in. Croissants, bread and butter pudding. Yeah, these are just your regular digestives, just the same as the UK. Milk chocolate digestives, and then you've got the dark chocolate ones, and then regular digestives. Keeps going up in price.
It used to be about 50 cents and now it's 90 cents.
50 cents, now 90 cents.
But so, they do English milk.
But they do English milk, so there's your fresh milk. Yeah.
Passion fruit is so good.
You recommend again, that one, yeah?
It used to be 70 cents, now it's €1.
It used to be 70 cents.
I mean, what?
I know a lot of people recommend this. It's quite thick. But if you mix it with fizzy water or lemonade, it's really nice. Now, I use a lot of chickpea flour because I make my own onion barges. And if you do too, or you like chickpea flour, there's chickpea flour, you can get it. These toffees, they're all right. They're nothing special, but they're, if you like your toffee, they're okay. Now, it's been 20 years we've been here, so I'm not sure whether this is what I remember of English bread, but this is what we use. And for me, that's just a plain white bread, similar to the UK white slice. You can get it in a large, we're getting a small. And then these, brioche burgers, those are for your standard size. You do get those if you can't get the others, but we get the smaller ones that you get in a sort of a pack of four.
This is,
but whatever you do, what's up?
This is brown sugar. You want the brown sugar instead of white sugar, right. And then you've also got icing sugar. Normal icing sugar. Because some people don't always know what it is.
Yeah, that's icing sugar.
Okay.
Show them
the... okay. Yeah. It's not as expensive as English stuff either.
And
that sugar's gone through the roof.
That's brown sugar. And this stuff's gone through the roof. $1.35, doubled in price that. So whatever you do, don't make the mistake that I see a lot of people when they come over here, they buy something called Bimbo. They make all kinds of bread. It's rubbish. It's not good. Don't bother. White English bread, that's what I'd say that was. And then Charlie normally gets this one, which has a few brown bread. Yeah, don't get Bimbo. You'll see it everywhere, you'll see the vans everywhere. They don't actually sell any here, I can't believe it, they used to. These are pretty plain. You want to put cheese or spreads or whatever on, those are all right. I want to show you this, so there's your tuna. They do tuna pie. Yes, they do. I know, sounds weird. Tuna pie. Do you like tuna in a pie?
But what they started doing recently is that they do a chicken pie. So that's like a chicken in, like, you know, like your regular chicken pie, white sauce. And they're good.
Bolognese one, never tried it.
But the chicken pie, I recommend that. Now,
croissants in Mercadona are fine. These are all the rage at the moment. And these are your normal standard Portuguese egg custards. Those are nice. Don't know what you're paying for your baked beans in the UK, but over here, Heinz baked beans, £1.75. They used to be 75. Crazy.
Good stock.
What's that for? Making
for soups?
Soups,
making soups and stuff, yeah.
Yep, there you go.
Vegetables you can make anyway.
These are good for making soups. Charlie recommends those. If she recommends them, they must be alright. Retired pastry chef. Yeah. No, I haven't showed them, no. So every now and again, I've seen people running out of tea bags. Now, you wouldn't expect it, but you can get tea bags. Here you go, look. £1.75.
Like a box of 40.
These here, can't work out what these are. These are small little pack of empanadas. So there's 16 in there, so if you want to make some little pies, little round, and they'll make the empanadas. That's those. Don't really recommend any of this. Calzone, I've not tried. Again, don't recommend the pizzas. I've seen a few of you that's been over this year and you've all recommended these. Now, these have only been put in the last year. Well, 2 years, the last year. And you can get half a chicken with potatoes. So it's those potatoes there. And you get half a chicken. That's €6. You can get just the potatoes or you can get just the chicken hot. Recommend the potatoes are lovely. Charlie gets those if we're being lazy. Now, these are all pretty standard wherever you go. If you're going to have a pizza, I'd have one from in here. These are your chicken, little chicken bites. Now, the one thing I like here is the Russian salad. That is really nice. That's a nice Russian salad. They do it here, the Russian salad, and that one is much better, but it's a bit more expensive. Coleslaw's fine.
Yeah. Hummus over here is really good. You've got some couscous ready made as well, which is spicy, which is really nice.
Couscous. Yeah, and we have used most of these things here when we were doing the barbecues, and we've got vegetarians in and vegans, and it's all absolutely fine. These are alright, these. So you actually don't look like you're getting many, but if you get these are your barbecue ribs. Chicken wings. You can always add your own sauce to them if you want to. If you don't like, they're not that saucy, those. These are covered in barbecue sauce. And I normally get one of each, throw them in the air fryer. Makes a right mess of the air fryer, but if I don't fancy making my own ribs. Yeah, these tortillas are fine as well. You get one with onion and one with just potato. So there's two different types. And then you've got your aglioli, which is garlic mayonnaise. Cooked chickens, absolutely fine. Would not recommend buying any of these ready meals. I'd never see anybody eating those. Nor the sandwiches.
Meat sides are alright. The salamis are alright.
Those are okay. You recommend those, yeah?
Yeah, they're good. I always have to spend the most to get the best.
In here, the only decent ham.
That one will be okay.
And that one.
Some of the other ones I'm not sure about.
These ones I do not recommend. Oh, look. Everywhere. Motorhomes down here. Anyway, I hope that helped. If it didn't, tough. You already knew. Fine. For those that don't know, just thought I'd try and help out because I see a lot of videos where people are struggling with pronunciation, which is fine. Try and speak Spanish if you can. If you can't, fine. But I know a lot of people that I've seen have they bought a lot of food that's rubbish. There is a lot of rubbish food over here. So we're just trying to bring our experience of living here as long as we have. And I think you guys are going to lose this. These are phasing out in the UK. You're not going to be getting those anymore. And that's not going to happen in Europe, in case you want to know. Just the UK. So there's a yapper. So there you go. I'm gonna. You gonna say bye, Charlie?
Bye. See you later.
Right. So we're going home now. I'm just gonna help Charlie pack up. Catch you on the next one, guys.